Having understood inodes and the basic characteristics of the extended file system, let's now consider its merits and compare it with the FAT system. File creation means grabbing an inode and updating the parent directory. This is not substantially different from FAT. File growth just means grabbing a new data block and updating the inode. No big deal. We are still efficient in terms of space. There's a little waste in potentially unused fields in the inodes, and the indirection tables are space that would not be used if the file were stored in a FAT system. But this is usually going to be small compared to the whole size of a file. As for access time, it is true that the inodes add an extra layer of indirection as we go through the directory tree. A directory points to the inode for a file rather than to the first data of the block. Because inodes are cached in memory, however, this performance cost is minimal. Much more important is that the inodes link the data blocks together in a tree-like structure with a high branching factor, as many as an indirection table can hold. This makes for much better random access than one gets from the linked list chaining of the FAT format, at least for large files.